Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on inventor's claim. Here is the question. Whatever is given in this, I'll write that in the form of data. Now it is given that an inventor claims that a new heat cycle will develop 0.4 kilowatts for a heat addition. Develops means this much is the work which is produced. So I'll write down work done is 0.4 kilowatts for a heat addition of 32.5 kilojoule per minute. So that is Q suffix A, heat addition 32.5 kilojoule per minute. Next, the temperature of heat source is 1990 Kelvin. So the source temperature will be always the maximum temperature. So T max will be 1990 Kelvin, and that of sink will be the minimum temperature, that is 850 Kelvin. So minimum temperature is 850. We have to find out, is his claim possible? So is his claim true or false? That is, whatever the inventor is claiming, that is his engine or heat cycle produces 0.4 kilowatt with heat addition of 32.5 kilojoule per minute working between these temperature ranges, that we have to prove whether he is saying true or false. Let us get started with the solution. I'll write down that since efficiency of Carnot cycle is given by, the efficiency of Carnot cycle we are using, and Carnot cycle is to be used because out of all the cycles through which we are calculating the efficiency, Carnot cycle is that cycle which gives us maximum efficiency. So efficiency of Carnot, it is given by maximum temperature minus minimum temperature upon maximum temperature. Therefore, your T max is 1990 Kelvin, so 1990 minus T min is 850 Kelvin, so 850 divided by T max, which is 1990. So therefore, the efficiency of Carnot cycle on calculation, it comes out to be 0.573, or we can say 57.3%. I will keep this as equation number 1. Now, the efficiency of Carnot is maximum. It means out of the temperature limits which is given in the problem, we cannot get efficiency more than 57.3%. because that is the Carnot efficiency. So to check the efficiency of the inventor's engine, we will calculate its efficiency also and compare it with Carnot. So here I'll write down, therefore, efficiency of inventor's engine is given by, that will be denoted by a general formula, which is efficiency is equal to work done upon heat supplied or heat added. So therefore, work done, it is given as 0.4 kilowatts, and heat added, it is in the form of kilojoule per minute. So 32.5, I'll divide it by 60 to get it in the form of kilojoule per second, because in the numerator it is in terms of kilojoule per second, that is kilowatts. So on calculation, I'll get efficiency of inventor's engine is equal to, my answer is, it is 0.738, or I can say 73.8%. Next, I'll say that since the efficiency of inventor's engine is greater than the efficiency of Carnot engine, and we know that There cannot be an engine which produces an efficiency more than that of Carnot. So if we compare in equation 1, the efficiency was 57.3. So if Inventor's engine would have been having efficiency less than this value, then his claim would have been true. But here his efficiency is 73.8%, which is more than 57.3%. So we'll say that therefore the Inventor's claim is false. It means whatever he is saying in the problem, that is its engine is producing a power of 0.4 kilowatt, and the heat addition is 32.5 kilojoule per minute, working between the temperature limits of 1990 Kelvin and 850 Kelvin. So it cannot be possible that his engine is producing such high efficiency, which is going beyond the Carnot cycle. And we know that whatever out of all the cycles, Carnot cycle will give us the maximum efficiency. So if his efficiency would have been less than 57.3%, then his claim would have been true. But here, since it is crossing 57.3%, we can say that the efficiency of Inventor's engine is greater than that of Carnot engine. And with this, whatever he is claiming, that is false. And with this, we complete the problem.